in the lead as expected. Frank Busemann, the young German, the world junior high hurdles champion, in second place. Erki Nuhl in third. Chris Huffings in fourth. Hämäläinen in fifth. They're the big names. Plasiat, champion of the past, in eighth place, the Frenchman. It's a good competition, this. Mike Smith, the Canadian, drawn on the first lane of this third heat of the 110 metres hurdles. Bajonk, Benet, Magnussen, the Icelander, Nuhl, Damashek, Huffins, Ganyev, and Schmara. Well, this third heat represents those still in with a chance of honours here. This is Pajonk, the German, 14.51. He was fourth in Götzis recently, so he's quite useful. Benet, the Spaniard, in 19th place overall. He's got a 14.18 best time in the high hurdles. Next to him, Magnussen, the Icelander. He's doing well. He's in 9th place overall. 14.19 his best time. Erki Nuhl, well, he might have a bit of a problem here. On paper, 14.79 his best. He was 10th in the European Championships a couple of seasons ago, 4th in the World Championships, but this hurdle's not his best event. Damashek, another 14.6 man. He's 11th overall, another World Junior Championship finalist. Huffins, the only man in the field on paper who's dipped below 14 seconds, 13.91. He was third in the American Championships with 7 personal bests. Ganyev of Uzbekistan, he's 7th overall. He was 8th in the last Olympic final. And Chmara of Poland on the near side, he's 12th after the first day. Difficult conditions. Incidentally, Chmara didn't finish in the World Championships last year. He did quite well in the World University Games. But really, tough conditions. It's been raining. The track's just starting to dry out, so there'll be a little bit more speed in it. But all of this is comparative. The time's relating to points. And O'Brien, incidentally, who will go in the next heat, got a first aid total of 4,592. Erki Nuhl and this man, Chris Huffins. Huffins got 4,448. Erki Nuhl, 4,457. And it might well be here that Huffins takes over from Nuhl. Now, Smith, Pajonk, Benet, Magnussen, Nuhl, Damashek, Huffins, Ganyev, and Chmara. The third heat, or time trial, we should say, in this decathlon. The first event of the second day. Very, very difficult for these athletes, this event. And Huffins, using that sprint speed, is already up in the lead. And in the fourth lane is Magnussen of Iceland. Huffins and Magnussen, these two, with the Spaniard Benet coming through. Huffins, Magnussen, these two, and Benet. Well, the time, 14.11, and that's pretty quick. We'll do a translation on that. That's worth 960 points. And we'll see how far on the replay Erki Nuhl was behind, because remember, as I said, third and fourth places. Now, Nuhl is in the fifth lane. Now, let's see what he does, the Estonian.
Well, Stuart, it's amazing. If you count five from the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see Erki Nuhl there in the blue and black vest of Estonia. And it's incredible that this man can run about 10.6 seconds for the 100 meters. But he's all over the place in the hurdles. He's knocked five down in a row. Chris Huffins there just a little bit off balance. The Icelander coming through well. But actually, Huffins hurdling very cleanly indeed.
I would certainly think that on that performance that Huffins would go ahead of Nuhl. There's a big, big gap between them. He's tall, he's rangy, he's a good hurdler. Anyone who can go below 14 seconds, remember the legs are tired after the first day, the 400 meters being the last event of the first day. And Huffins, incidentally, ran 48.83. 2.04 for the high jump, 15.57 for the shot put, had a poor long jump at 7.49, but began with a 10.47, 100 metres, and it's that sort of speed that takes him to 14.11. It's a good start for the day for Huffins. Look at the determination on his face. Good run by the American, and I would think that's moved him up a place overall.
There's the result of Heat 3. Chris Huffins coming through in 14.10. Magnussen in second place, 14.22. And Benet of Spain in third, 14.36. Erki Nuhl in last place, 15.03. But a very strong pole vault to come.